Hi students, how are you? Hope you all are in today. I would like to welcome you all and congratulate you for joining class 2. This is our first meeting. So I would like to introduce myself. I am your English teacher. This year we are going to study different form of writing skill like story writing, letter writing, unseen passages, essay writing, and we also discuss lots of other topic in competition. Do you know what we are learning today? Today we are going to learn essay writing. What? Essay writing. Take out one notebook, pencil, eraser. What do you have to take out? One notebook, pencil and eraser to make note about the essay writing. Okay, so what is an essay writing? An essay is a short piece of writing that describes particular subject or a topic. What? An essay is a short piece of writing which describes the particular subject or topic. An essay is a composition made up of several paragraphs. Of each of these paragraphs has a collection of connected sentences on a given topic. A well-written essay usually has a one title and a three paragraph. What? One title and a three paragraph. So essay is divided into three distinct parts. Part of essay writing. First one is introduction. What? Introduction. Introduction is a beginning of an essay writing. The purpose of introduction is to introduce the topic to the reader. An introduction is usually shorter. What is an introduction? Introduction is a beginning of an essay. The purpose of introduction is to introduce the topic to the reader. The introduction is usually shorter. Then after, body. The body is the middle part of an essay writing. What? The body is the middle part of an essay writing. That's give the most amount of detail about the topic. It is the main section of an essay that follows the introduction. What is essay writing? I have already told you. But after that we have to describe title, introduction, body. Right now I'm just explaining once again what is body. Body is the middle part of an essay writing. That gives the most amount of detailed information about the topic. It is the main section of an essay that follows the introduction. After that, conclusion. The conclusion is the end of an essay. It is the most important part of an essay. So now we have already covered the part of essay writing. So next is our format of an essay writing. Format of an essay writing. First, title. The essay begins with the title. The title should not only give an idea about the main topic covered, but also capture the interest of the reader. It means the essay begins with the title. We know that. The title should not only give an idea of the main topic covered, but also capture the interest of the reader. Let's look what we need to cover under the format of an essay writing. First, introduction. The introduction is the beginning of an essay writing. The purpose of introduction is to introduce the topic to the reader. And the third point is the introduction is usually shorter than the following paragraphs as it only tells the reader what to expect in the essay. After that, you have to leave one line. How many line? One line. The topic has introduced, we need to write the body of a essay. Body. The body is the middle part of essay that gives the most amount of the detail of the topic. It is the main section of an essay writing that follows the introduction. Again, you have one line. How many lines, student? One line. The conclusion is the last section of an essay. Conclusion. The conclusion is the most important part of an essay. It follows the body and must smoothly end the essay. The conclusion sum up the essay. The conclusion uses word or sentence that signals the end of an essay. So what is conclusion? Conclusion is the most important part of the essay. It follows the body and must smoothly end the essay. The conclusion sum up all the essay. The conclusion uses word or sentences that signals the end of the essay. I know you all understand the format of an essay writing, but how do you write an essay based on these parts? That's your question. I know. The another question, which point to include in which part? Don't worry, student. I will structure your essay. I will help you to put down your points into this section. We need to be very careful while writing an essay. The essay is written on the basic of a given topic. Sometimes beginning of an essay can be hardest part. Before beginning to write, we must carry out a few initial steps. First, we must spend some time thinking about the topic. That will help us with the point that can be included in the essay. So far, we have completed what is an essay writing, parts on essay writing, and the format of an essay writing. So I know, kids, we have covered each and everything regarding essay writing. So, but you know what is our topic? Yes, our topic is an essay writing, and the title is The Peacock. What, student? The Peacock. Right now we have collected lots of information related to peacock. So my first question is, which is the most beautiful bird and colorful bird? Yes, student? Yes, perfect. The peacock is the most beautiful and colored bird. Next question, which bird is our national bird? Yes, student, fast. Yes, the peacock is our national bird. Student, you know, peacock is a male bird. If the male bird is a peacock, then what is the female bird called? Yes, student, the male bird is called a peacock and the female bird is called a pig hen. What? Pig hen. The introduction parts complete. Now we will start with the body of an essay. As of now, we have completed introduction part. Let's recap. Which is the most beautiful and the colorful bird? Yes, peacock is the most beautiful and the colorful bird. Which bird is our national bird? Yes, Peacock is our national bird. And what is the female bird called? The female bird is called peahen. Let's start with the body of an essay. In this part, we detail about the topic. Let's answer some questions that will help you in describing about peacock. Where is the crown in the peacock's body? Yes, student. Where is that? Tell me, student. Peacock has a crown on its head which looks like very royal and majestic. Next question. Do you know the colors of a peacock's neck? Yes, student. I know you know all. A peacock neck is dark blue in color and it's long and shiny. Okay. Next question. How is the peacock's feather? It has a beautiful and multicolored feather. How is the feather? Beautiful and multicolored feathers. Okay. Do you know when a peacock dances? Tell me, in which season? Yes, in the rainy season, a peacock dances as it spreads its wings out like a fan. Interesting, na? Let's recap. Where is the crown in the peacock's body? You know? Yeah, peacock has a crown on its head which looks very royal and majestic. Next question. Do you know the color of the peacock's neck? Yes, peacock has a beautiful dark blue color neck and it's long and shiny. Next question. How is the peacock's feather? Peacock has a beautiful and multicolored feathers. Next question. Do you know when a peacock dances? Yes, in the rainy season, a peacock dances as it spreads its wings out like a fan. We have already detailing so many information about the peacock. The last section of an essay is conclusion. Here we end the essay. Can peacock fly? Tell me, students. Yes, peacock can fly for a short distance. Next question. What is the use of peacock's feather? Tell me, students, what's the use of a peacock feather? Peacock's feather is used for decorative purpose. Anything like a small purse, small toy, there are so many uses. The next question, why peacock are called farmer's friend? Yes, student, a peacock is a farmer's friend as it eats worm and insect. That's the reason people are called farmer's friend. So we have completed everything regarding essay writing. So now it's time to start writing. How to write essay? First is the title. What's the title? The peacock. And then after what's come? Introduction. The peacock is a very beautiful and colorful bird. The peacock is a very beautiful and colorful bird. It is our national bird. It is our national bird. The male bird is called a peacock and the female bird is called a peahen. The male bird is called a peacock and the female bird is called a peahen. Body. Peacock has a crown on its head which looks very royal and majestic. Peacock has a crown on its head which looks very royal and majestic. It has a long, shiny and dark blue neck. It has a long, shiny and dark blue neck. It has a beautiful and multicolor feathers. It has a beautiful and multicolor feather. In the rainy season, a peacock dances and it spread its wings out like a fan. In the rainy season, a peacock dances and it spreads its wings out like a fan. Conclusion. A peacock can fly for a short distance. A peacock can fly for a short distance. Its feathers are used for decorative purposes. Its feathers are used for decorative purposes. A peacock is a farmer's friend as it eats worms and insects. A peacock is a farmer's friend as it eats worm and insect. Students, we have completed whole essay. Now, the times come where we have to write in your notebook. In the competition, we have to follow some rules. This is your notebook. You have your notebook with you, students? Yes. So, there is some rule in the competition. We have to follow. First, every time you have to write on a right side. Which side? Right side. Which side? Show me your right hand, student. Yes, this is your right hand. And always you have to leave left hand side page. Which side page? Left hand side page. Show me your left hand. Yeah, this is your left hand. Same like this picture. You can see on the left side, topic is written. What is that? Essay writing. On the right side, you can see the title is mentioned. What? The peacock. So understand what we have to do? Always write on a right hand side and leave which side? Left side. Which side? Left side. Only you have to write two things. One, the topic, and the second one is the date. Mention on the left hand side, and rest everything you have to write on a right hand side. So first paragraph is, the peacock is a very beautiful and colorful bird. It is our national bird. The male bird is called a peacock and the female bird is called a peahen. After that, what do you have to do? You have to leave one line because that's the format of an essay writing. So always you have to leave how many lines? One line after each and every paragraph. Peacock has a crown on its head which looks very royal and majestic. It has a long, shiny and dark blue neck. It has beautiful and multicolored feathers. It has beautiful and multicolored feather. In the rainy season, a peacock dances and it spread its wing out like a fan. In the rainy season, a peacock dances and it spreads its wings out like a fan. And after that, again you have to leave one line. How many lines? One line. You have to always follow the format of an essay writing. See, on the left side you can see the page is empty, and you can see that on the right side you can, everything is written. Peacock can fly for a short distance. A peacock can fly for a short distance. Its feathers are used for decorative purposes. Its feather are used for decorative purposes. A peacock is a farmer's friend as it eats worms and insect from the field. So we have already complete our essay writing.
So, let's quickly take a look at all the points we have learned in this session on an essay writing. So, first it was, what is an essay writing? Let's start. An essay is a short piece of writing that describes the particular topic or subject. An essay is a composition made up of several paragraphs. Each of these paragraphs has a collection of connected sentences on a given topic. A well-written essay usually has a one title and a three paragraph. How many? One title and a three paragraph. First one is introduction. Second one is body, and the third one is conclusion. So I have to introduce introduction. The introduction is the beginning of an essay. The purpose of introduction is to introduce the topic to the reader. The introduction is usually shorter. Then after body. The body is the middle part of an essay that gives the most amount of detail of the topic. It is the main section of an essay that follows the instruction. Then after conclusion. The conclusion is the end of an essay. That's the most important part of an essay. So first we have covered what is an essay writing, part of an essay writing. Now format of an essay writing. Always remember, first one is title, then after introduction, then leave one line, body, again leave one line, and the conclusion. So we have covered each and everything about the essay writing. Students, did you know male peacocks begin to grow their colorful tails only after they are about 3 years old? Yes, students, male peacocks begin to grow their colorful tails only and after they are about 3 years old. It's a nice information. We have completed each and everything regarding the peacock. So I give you one homework. Write an essay writing on the parrot. And you know, parrot is also a beautiful bird. It is a talking bird. Its feathers are green in color and it has a red beak. Oh my god, there are so many information. Now this time you have to collect all the information and send me the essay on the parrot. So I just send the one link in the description box. Please fill it and send it to me. Thank you, kids.